When you think of the genetic engineering that's happening in the world today, you probably imagine it happening at a university or a big biotechnology firm full of people in white lab coats using sophisticated and expensive equipment to do the complex and delicate work of gene editing. For most people, this is probably a pretty reassuring image. It's all so professional and well-regulated, right? Well, as it turns out, there is a do-it-yourself gene therapy kit available online that allows you to edit genomes at home. Until recently, editing DNA required sophisticated labs, years of experience, and several thousands of dollars. But with the breakthrough of a genetic engineering tool called CRISPR-Cas9 that is not only fast but also cheap and relatively easy, gene editing has entered a new era. Now, you can order a DIY genetic engineering home lab kit for just under $150 that allows anyone to re-engineer DNA in surprising ways. CRISPR-Cas9 is a gene editing tool that allows scientists to edit DNA by deleting or adding specific genes to create specific mutations. It is a remarkably precise, step-by-step technique that's easy enough to be performed at home in a DIY lab. Using this tool, geneticists can edit stem cells in a petri dish, tweak genes inside fertilized eggs, or even target multiple genes at once, giving rise to drastically unique and designed DNA sequences. The CRISPR-Cas9 DIY kit includes all the necessary ingredients that you need to edit DNA in bacteria at home. You simply follow the instructions, and in about 10 hours over a period of 2 days, you can engineer a bacteria that is immune to an antibiotic called streptomycin. There is one obvious question that's probably popping into your head. Is this dangerous? According to the DIY toolkit company, the bacteria they are using are non-pathogenic, which means they can't make you sick. But even if this particular kit isn't harmful, what might home scientists be able to do with CRISPR in the future? A growing number of biohackers have already learned enough that they have begun to experiment on themselves. After all, what could possibly go wrong when you're tampering with your own genetics in a DIY lab? A year ago, a biohacker injected himself at a conference with modified DNA that he hoped would make him more muscular. In a separate incident, a biotech company livestreamed a man injecting himself with a homebrew treatment for HIV. As a result of this experiment, his viral load actually increased. An executive from the same company injected himself with what he hoped would be a herpes treatment. He died 1 week later. According to researchers, trying to eliminate a host of debilitating and currently incurable disorders by means of a simple injection is a massive oversimplification of medical science. Apart from the long and complex ethical arguments against casual or amateur gene editing, there is also the chance that someone may create something truly dangerous. Researchers fear that if these backyard biohackers were to create a biological weapon from scratch, a killer that would bounce from host to host, capable of reaching millions of people, unrestrained by time or distance, it's not unreasonable to expect that they'd start by selling their so-called treatments online. As we enter the age of genetic modification, we will be presented with several ethical and even legal challenges. Who should we trust with our genetics? What limits should there be on genetic modification? The list goes on and on. We need to spend time now thinking about these questions, or else we may be faced with a problem that only gets more complicated as time goes on.